I'm from Blue Springs, Missouri. Had a pretty standard upbringing. It's a nice, quasi-quiet suburban town. For a living, before all this crazy idol stuff really started coming into full swing, I was a drink slinger. I bartended at a bar called The Blank Slate in Tulsa, and it was cool because it's also a music venue, so I was able to play shows there from time to time. It's the only job I've ever had where you can fully be who you are and nobody's gonna fault you for it. In fact, they usually tip you a little better. So, and I love it, but I certainly would rather be here. I'm singing Eleanor Rigby. This song, I think, is already so powerful. I think if I were to play guitar on it, it would just be overkill. I definitely don't think it would serve the song. You really have to be on your game, because everybody knows these songs. And so to do it justice, you know, a B-plus effort isn't gonna cut it anymore. There's 11 other people gunning for the same spot as me, and they're all fantastic, so. I got my work cut out for me, but the goal is to leave it on the stage.
No, I would not.
What I'm saying.
No.
I think you would come in.
Another one from Revolver with Eleanor Rigby. It is David Cook.
Eleanor Rigby picks up the rice in a church where a wedding has been. Lives in a dream, waits at the window, wearing a face that she keeps in a jar by the door. Who is it for? All the lonely people, where do they all come from? All the lonely people, where do they all belong? Father McKenzie, writing the words to a sermon that no one will hear. No one comes near, look at him working, wearing his socks in the night when there's nobody there. What does he care? All the lonely people, where do they all come from? All the lonely people, where do they all belong? I'm looking at all the lonely people.
See, look at that, man. You can definitely rock out on Idol. See, that proves it right there. You can rock out on Idol. You can rock out on the Beatles. You're doing your thing. Started a little kind of unsafe for me. You had a little pitch problem in the first part. But, dude, once you hit that chorus, dude, it was rocking. Let go. You got this. Come on, do this. You got this.
Dave Cook. I've been telling everyone you are the dark horse. This is proving there's more than one horse in this race.
Exactly.
You're a thoroughbred. I think that you are fantastic. Each week you come out. I love seeing you just as a front man here on the stage. We all know you're a front man with your band, but you are the front man here on American Idol.
Thank you. The question is, if he's a thoroughbred, what son?
The handicap. He's a stallion? Oh my God.
Donkey.
Donkey?
Yeah.
Thank you. David, I thought it was brilliant. I think, David, for 2 weeks now, you know, Paul is right. You know, if this show remains a talent competition rather than a popularity competition,
right,
you actually could win this
yep.
entire show.
Yeah.
I feel like last week was a big moment for you.
Well, yeah.
It was a big moment for
yeah.
you.
I got lucky, man. The song fell into my lap at the right time. And you've got
the confidence now.
Oh, God. Well, yeah. I mean, but there's always next week.
Simon, you're on your game tonight. Well said. If you want to vote for David, dial 1-866-IDOL-06. It's 1-866-436-5706. If you're with AT&T, you can text the word vote to 5706 from your wireless phone. Don't vote until the end of the show. All right, thank you very much, David. Good luck, buddy. Enjoy that. We're going to take a break right now. We come back with Brooke White after the break.